Hi, I'm Justin. I'm one of the gunsmiths here at the Village Arms, and we want to do a quick video today on the basic disassembly and reassembly of a Glock pistol. I know they're simple guns, but it seems like every week one of our customers is here trying to figure out how to take it apart and clean it. So we're going to do a quick video on it. I'm not going to go over how to take the entire pistol apart, but we're going to do enough that if you go out and shoot a couple hundred rounds, you can come back to your house and clean it. So I have here, this is my personal Glock. It's a Model 19, one of the older generations. I'm not going to go over every single part there is in every single generation. So if you see something different in your pistol, don't immediately panic, but they're almost identical. So anyway, before you start this, for those of you who haven't figured it out yet, you should definitely make sure that this gun is unloaded. Because when you take this apart, there's a good chance, actually, you will shoot yourself if it is loaded. So with pointing the gun in the safe direction and your finger off the trigger, make sure you remove your magazine, lock your slide open, and visually and physically look into the breech and check and make sure that it is not loaded. Alright, when you take the slide off this gun, you have to pull the trigger. When if there's a bullet in there, it's definitely going to go off. So, ease the slide back forward after you've made sure that there's no ammo in the gun. Now, with your right hand, and this can depend if you're left or right hand dominant, with your right hand, ease the slide back an eighth of an inch, just enough so you take the pressure off of these two little buttons here. There's one located on either side of the pistol. When you take the pressure off of them, you pull both of them down. Holding both of them down, let the slide go forward. You know you've done it right when the slide almost tries to pull off the front. At that point, all you have to do, and still make sure you're pointing in a safe direction, pull the trigger, and it'll allow you to pull the slide off the gun. Now, I'm not going to go over how to take the frame apart. That's a whole nother ball game. I wouldn't be too concerned about it unless you've just shot 1,200 rounds and you got grime everywhere. But for the most part, you wouldn't really need to clean this unless you've shot, yeah, like I said, over 1,000 rounds. So I just shot this the other day, so if it looks a little grimy, bear with me. But now, if you do want to clean the frame, there's a couple ways you can go about that. If you've been carrying it regularly and you have a ton of lint fuzzies in there, if you have access to it, it's great. But compressed air works wonders because it'll get all those lint fuzzies out real quick. But if you don't, the simplest thing you can do is either use a nylon brush. You can brush in along at all the rails, in down here at the barrel gap. You can also use Q-tips to get into any available gaps, and you can use a rag to clean off whatever you want. You can get most of the carbon fouling and lint fuzzies out this way. If you really want to get involved with it, they're not too terribly hard to take apart, but like I said, we're not going to cover that here because it's not really necessary for 200 rounds of shooting. Basically, the only thing you need to really be concerned about is your slide. When you get the slide off the gun, your recoil guide pops right out along with the spring, and your barrel will slide out. Now, as far as these parts are concerned, your recoil guide isn't going to gunk up after shooting 10 rounds, kind of like your frame. If you want to, you know, if it's not particularly dirty, you can get most of it simply with a cloth or a nylon brush. If it's really gunked up, you can take it to the next level. Here at the shop, we use a couple different things. You may have something different at home, but this is what we use. We've been using it for a long time, never had an issue with it. If you're looking to clean it out, Powder Blaster works really well. They come with a provided spray tip, so you can get, you know, concentrate quite a bit of spray down into any of these parts and get a lot of the gunk out, or you can leave it sit a while. Now, after you do that, it'll evaporate and it'll get pretty dry. So at which point, you can either use a spray can or a spray can of REM oil, which works really well, especially if you're trying to coat a large surface. If you're trying to do a small part, a little bottle of liquid REM oil with just a little nozzle in the end, you can put it pretty much wherever you want. Let's see. Now, as a general rule, if your gun is dripping oil when you're putting it back together, you're not going to be in for a rewarding experience the next time you do it. These guns you could probably put together and run without a single drop of oil in them, and they will probably function. but you don't need to. You got oil in hand, so you may as well use it. But if your gun is dripping oil, it's not good. Glock advises, and I don't know where I have my Glock manual at the moment, they do advise putting a drop or two of oil here and there on various assemblies of the gun. But, yeah, keep it to a drop or two. If it's dropping off the gun, it's not good. Your gun shouldn't look like you have used motor oil coming out of it when it's after you're done shooting. So yeah, cleaning out the guide rod assembly isn't hard to do. The barrel, the outside's easy to get to. It's a very hard treated surface. Carbon won't stick to it like a magnet, so it's not the hardest thing to get rid of. So basically a rag will wipe off everything. As far as cleaning the bore is concerned, if you have any of your pro shot stuff, you can attach a metal jag to it, push a patch down through, and a bristle brush. I'm not going to sit here and clean out mine because I know mine is very dirty. I still have to clean it. I'm not going to bore you with it. But if you put a wet patch down through your gun, then scrub it out several times with your bronze bristle brush, and then push a dry patch through to clean out all the gunk. And if you repeat that several times, your patches should get cleaner and cleaner when you're done. At the end, when you've got most of your fouling out of the barrel, simply push one more oily patch with either something like REM oil or CLP. Safariland makes CLP. It's what the military uses. It's good stuff. You can put any of that down your barrel to preserve it. And then when you put that down, simply run one more dry patch through so you don't have a ton of oil sitting in your bore. And that's about all you have to really do on your barrel. As far as the slide is concerned, there's a couple tricks to taking it apart. I don't know if you can see it very well. Here's your firing pin assembly. Right below it is this small plastic, for lack of a better word, shell. Now, Glock does make a specialty Glock tool, although it doesn't do anything any better than this little Bondus tool I have. Anything you can pretty much use to press down on this little piece of plastic. If you push down on this sleeve here, and you will have to put a little bit of pressure on to push it down. If you're absolutely struggling to do it, there's probably something wrong and you should see someone else tell you what's going on. But needless to say, if you push down on that, it'll allow you to push off your end cap. At which point, you can pull out your firing pin assembly, and in the back of the slide here there's also another assembly. This is the extractor rod and spring and detent. It pushes up against the front back of your extractor, runs through your slide and pushes up here on your extractor, which allows it to hook over and grab your round. Now to pull out your extractor and your firing pin stop, it doesn't take a whole lot of work. If you grab your extractor and wiggle it a couple times, let me just flip this around here. See if I can get this out. Sometimes it can be a little tricky. There, I just launched it. You can pull out your extractor and your firing pin stop. Most of these parts, just like your barrel, they've got a good hard coating on, and they really don't take a whole lot to clean off. A simple rag, and you can pretty much wipe off all the gunk that's on it. Now, if it is heavily fouled and you do need something to break through it, you can use powder blaster. That eats into it pretty good. And then use some sort of scraping tool, either an old dental pick or whatever you got. Preferably nothing that's going to actually mar the metal, but just enough to get the carbon steel out. And then you have your strip slide, which, for cleaning out the slide, a nylon brush will get all your loose dirt out of there. If you do need to break up any heavy carbon fouling that's in there, the powder blaster, again, will break through it. If you leave it sit for a while, it definitely gets the job done. And then if you need to get into any of these tiny grooves in your rails or in your firing pin channel here, Q-tips do the job. They're cheap, inexpensive, and they work great. So you can clean in all those tight little corners and clean off the bolt face. Now your bolt face is probably going to be your dirtiest part in the whole gun. So you can run your nylon brush through there if you have to. You can use a bronze bristle brush if it's really heavy. And you can get down into your extractor groove where it rides and clean all that out with a Q-tip and or a scraper or whatever. So they're not, unless you've been firing 1,000 rounds or something really heavy duty out of it, it ain't going to be hard to clean off. You really aren't going to have a whole lot of gunk piled up in it. So it really isn't too hard to get it done. So when you go back to put it together,